Looking for a great hosting solution? Check our website for prices. First, what you need to do is to update the server packages. You can do this by the following command. Once all the packages are updated, install the required dependencies using the following command. Next, we will also need to install libssl and libffi libraries to your system. You can download and install both by running the following command. Once all the packages are installed, you can proceed to the next step. You need to install the Elasticsearch. First, add the gpkg key with the following command. Next, add the Elasticsearch repository to the apt with the next command. Update the repository and install the Elasticsearch package with the following command. Once the Elasticsearch is installed, edit the Elasticsearch configuration file and set Java memory. Change the following clients. Save and close the file, then enable Elasticsearch service to start at system reboot with the following command. By default, Elasticsearch listens on the next port. You can check it with the following command. First, download the latest version of Arkime with the following command. Once the package is downloaded, install the downloaded package by running the next command. Once the Arkime is installed, run the following command to configure it. You will be asked to specify the network interface as shown. Type your network interface name and hit enter to continue. Once the configuration is finished, you should get the following output. Next, you will need to initialize the Elasticsearch Arkime configuration. You can do it by the following command. Next, create an admin user account for Arkime with the following command. Update the Yale database using by running the next command. Arkime is made from three components: Capture, Weaver, and Elasticsearch. So you will need to start the service for each component. You can start it by running the next commands. You can now check the status of both servers by running the following command. You can check the viewer log by running the next command, and also you can check the capture log by running the following command. At this point, Arkime is started and listened on next port. You can check it by using the following command. Now open your browser and check the Arkime web interface using your IP server and the next port. You will be asked to provide your admin username and password. Provide username and password and click on the sign in button. You should see the Arkime dashboard. That's it. If you have any question, please leave them in the comments.